score.
And I don't give a fuck.
Everyone, welcome to another Gore's Month of Horror. This is number 6, and again, I am doing a double feature where I review 2 movies in 1 video, which, to be honest, I like that format a little bit better than just reviewing 1 movie, because it gives me more, you know, it gives me more somewhat freedom with my videos, because I don't need to keep posting one up every time I want to review 1 movie. If I want to review 2, then I'll wait a couple days and then I'll post a review for 2 movies in 1 video, you know? So, I think it's a little better, so I'm going to do more of them. Also, right now, while you're watching this, maybe you're watching on Saturday, which I won't be there, but on Friday, I will be at Comic-Con. So, you're actually watching a video that was recorded before it was posted, which I do plenty anyway, so there you go. Anyway, the 2 movies I'm going to review today is, of course, the Dead Space animated movies. You got Dead Space Downfall, which I actually reviewed a couple of years ago for Gore's Month of Horror. And you have the semi-new one, whenever Dead Space 2 came out, earlier in 2011, I think. Yeah, 2011. You got Dead Space Aftermath, which I actually just recently saw because it kind of recently just went on Netflix. So I saw it, and yeah, that's a re-review, Downfall, and of course, this review, Aftermath. Let's do it. Dead Space Downfall is pretty simple. You have a crew of space engineers, just like Isaac Clarke from the video game, and they are tasked to go and find this strange artifact. This is actually a prequel to Dead Space 1 and 2, by the way. This strange thing they found on some planet, and of course that, you'll find out, is the marker from Dead Space 1 and 2. And they find this thing and they're like, alright, let's take samples and stuff, blah blah blah, because they're stupid and white. Well, actually, I think a couple of them are black. I think? I can't remember, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, they take samples and stuff, blah, 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 and of course, this little rock pillar thing that they find is the marker from Dead Space 1 and 2, and it turns people into these things called necromorphs, which are pretty much people, except they got morphed so badly that their, like, bones are sticking out, and they're completely sharp, they're tall as hell, they move fast, they got teeth that are, of course, you know, just extruding out from bone and stuff. It's hard to explain what they look like, but they're pretty disgusting creatures, and the story here pretty much follows the crew who, of course, went to go get the marker samples, trying to escape from this place by, of course, murdering a bunch of necromorphs and getting murdered themselves. And it's pretty simple. That's really the story. You just follow a bunch of pretty forgettable characters going through a spaceship and getting murdered. That's really the story. The story, for the most part, is pretty generic, but I actually do like a couple of things. One thing I like is that it is a prequel to Dead Space 1, which means you get to learn more about the ship that is in Dead Space 1 and in this film. You get to learn about what happened to the crew, you get to learn how it happened, you get to learn about each specific, not every crew member, but you get to know about certain specific crew members, and I don't know, I thought that was cool, and also I liked the tension in the movie. I thought there was actually some nice intense moments at times, because you're like, okay, everybody's gathering around, everything's peaceful and quiet, when the hell is a necromorph gonna pop out of a grate or something and kill someone? And there's a couple times where that happens, and it actually gets you off guard. I mean, it's kind of scary, but not overly scary, because it's those kind of jump scares where it's like, oh, that was kind of scary. I mean, I'll completely forget about it in the, like, next 2 minutes, and I'll never think about it and try to get scared again, but hey, it scared me at the moment, so it was okay, I guess. The story itself is generic, but pretty entertaining for the most part. And the voice acting, also, I would say there's actually a couple of standouts. Like, there's this whole dude, this big, bulky dude. I can't remember who the voice actor is. If you hear him, you'll know, because he always plays, like, those tough dudes. And I can't remember his name. I think it's, like, Kevin Michael Richardson, if I'm getting it right. But this is a big dude with, like, a chainsaw hand or something like that, or a laser sword hand or something. And he's pretty badass in this film, and he has a great voice. I love that dude. And there's a couple other voice actors that I actually kind of like, and there's a couple that really do fail to, you know, make me even believe in their characters at all. So yeah, it's mostly hit or miss, but I would say it's a little bit more hit than miss. So for the most part, I think Downfall has decent voice actors. As I said before, there are a couple of moments where it does, like, jump out and kind of scare you, but again, it's not those, like, psychological scares where it's like, oh, it's in your brain forever. It's not like Freddy Krueger or something where the face just burns into your head. No, it's not like that. But it has some decent jump scares that I didn't anticipate. And also, I like some of the gore, even though it is an animated movie, and that's kind of cheating in a way, because, you know, you don't need to use practical effects or special effects. You just draw some gooey, mushy things. But still, it looked pretty creepy at times. I like the designs of the necromorphs. I like some of the death scenes. There's this whole one death scene where someone gets cut in half from here to the head all the way to the dick. And I love that. And then they just split open like a freaking Mortal Kombat fatality. I loved it. And so, overall, I think the movie is fun. It's not all that scary. It has a couple moments. It does. And the characters, for the most part, are mostly forgettable. But, you know, it's bloody. It's gory. It's kind of fun. It's short. And it's an animated movie that went straight to DVD for a video game. It's not that bad, actually. So, you know what? I'm going to give Dead Space, Downfall, I'm going to give it a 27 out of 40. I actually kind of enjoyed it. But now, let's go on to Aftermath. The story for Dead Space Aftermath is actually set on the ship that was out to go and see what happened to the Ishimura, the ship from the first movie that I just talked about, and it actually is set on that ship, and I like the structure of the story, because in the beginning it's just a bunch of guards going in and trying to rescue some survivors in the O'Bannon, that's the ship's name, and they go and save these dudes, and one by one they're questioned about what happened on the Bannon, and that's where the plot comes in, because each one of these, I think five survivors, is questioned, and they have their own little backstory, and every time there's one backstory, there's always a different animation for each one of the backstories, which I thought was kind of cool, you know, a different animation style, because the whole story itself, when they're getting questioned and stuff, that's actually 3D modeling, but everything else is actually 2D, you know, Japanese style animation, which I thought was really cool. So yeah, I like that story, you know, just all the multiple viewpoints, all the different types of viewpoints. I thought that was really cool. The thing is, the story is still not very good even with the multiple viewpoints, because you don't really care about any of the characters or what happened. And even though the story isn't that great, I do like one thing this time, only one thing in this. And that is, of course, how it ties into the game, because this is before Dead Space 2, so it's a prequel of sorts to Dead Space 2, and of course a sequel to Dead Space 1 in a way. It ties the bridges, as you would like to say, and it actually does pretty decently. They actually introduce some characters that make sense to be there. They show a couple of scenes that make sense too, and I don't know, I thought it was actually kind of cool how they tied it into Dead Space 2. Again, I thought the voice acting for this movie was actually pretty good as well, just like the first one. Actually, I would think it's a little bit better, because I don't think there was any character that ever, you know, made me go, wow, that was a bad voice actor. There really wasn't. It was mostly just good voice actors for the most part. No standouts like the first movie, but no bad ones, which is, in my opinion, better, because bad voice actors really take me out of the movie sometimes, or the game, either way. And I thought the voice acting here, for the most part, was very solid. Now, what I didn't think was solid was the scares, because here it goes for more of a what happened before the necromorphs show up, because there is not that many necromorphs in this movie. If you're going into this expecting necromorphs to go screw some stuff up, I would say the first 40 minutes of this, like, 75-minute movie, you don't see no necromorphs. And when you do, they tear some stuff up. Not much, and it's kind of lame, to be honest, because I would love to see necromorphs just tear people up, just like in the first movie, which I thought was great. Here, you don't get that. Even though you do get some gore, you don't get enough of the necromorphs, which kind of sucks. You don't get enough of the necromorphs, you don't get that many scares, which also kind of sucks. I mean, you don't even get really any jump scares that really, you know, get you by surprise or anything. It's really just lame, but it's a lot of gore. Sure, there's plenty of blood in this movie. There's a whole scene where a rock crushes a dude, and you just see, you could slow it down, and it's like gushy and gory. It's disgusting, and it's like, oh my god, they did a lot with that. And also, I do like how they do the animation styles, because sometimes you'll see gore in one animated style, and you'll be like, that's cool, and then you'll see gore in another one, and it'll be like, whoa, that's cool too. I got a variety in how much blood and gore I got. Yeah! Speaking of the animation styles, this is another problem, because, okay, I said it was kind of cool before how it would switch to different kind of styles, even though a couple of the stories kind of looked the same in parts to me, but whatever. I thought it was cool. The thing is, the 2D animated sequences, all the Japanese animated sequences, all that, whatever, look great. They did. They did really look good. It was very well drawn, very well animated, looked damn good. I like the designs, how they're different for each story. That was cool. My main problem is the main story 3D. The 3D in this movie is some of the worst 3D I've seen in a movie in so long. It's some of the worst 3D animation I've seen ever. It looks so bad. It really does. And maybe they were trying to go for more of a cel-shaded look to it, because that's the only way I could see these computer graphics working. But that does not work for a Dead Space movie. So even if they went for that, it doesn't work. And it's horrible in this film. It really does. And it kind of distracts from the entire movie. So, yeah, this 3D cel-shaded animation is horrible in this film. Overall, I think there's less scares, a good amount of gore, some okay characters, good voice acting, the story isn't very interesting, but I like how it ties into Dead Space 2, and the animation is either really damn good or horrible. So it's all over the place for this one. So I definitely like this a little bit less. I'm gonna give it a 22 out of a 40, because I do like some of those animation styles. I do like some of the gore. Don't care for many of the characters, but I do like how it ties into Dead Space too. So there you go. 22 out of 40 for this. Did I give it to? Yeah, 22 out of 40. I'm completely forgetting what I'm giving these movies nowadays. 22 for Aftermath and Downfall gets a 27, 26, 27, whatever. Freaking. It doesn't even matter. So anyway, there you go. There's my double feature review. I'm going to go to sleep because I'm tired as fudge. I hope you enjoyed it. Look forward to a Sinister and maybe something else review tomorrow. Thank you and goodbye.